So now discuss differences between crystalline solid state and amorphous solid state. So consider three columns. One is property, crystalline solid, amorphous solid. Now in that first property, anisotropic property. So generally crystalline solids are anisotropy. So these are called as anisotropy. But amorphous solids are called as isotropy. Isotropic substances, these are anisotropic substances. Nature of solid, next property, nature of solid, these are true solids, means true substances. These are pseudo first order substances, pseudo first order substances. And order of constituent, okay, order of constituent of particles, order of constituent of particles. So means what is the arrangement? So crystalline solids are generally shows long range order, these are shows short range order. So means amorphous are short range substances, these are long range substances. And next one, so cleavage or breakage. So the cleavage of solid state. So whenever the crystalline solids are undergoes cleavages, it gives a smooth surface or plain surface. Means it is divided into two species. Those two species are appears as a regular manner or smooth surface or plain surface. But in amorphous solid, whenever the edge of the material, the edge of the solid state, the solid undergoes cleavage, it is appears as irregular manner. And these are having the heat of fusion. So next property, heat of fusion. Okay, the crystalline solids are shows high heat of fusion. There is no heat of fusion here. Heat of fusion is very less character. These are melting point, boiling point for crystalline solid is more. These are shows less melting point and boiling point character. So these are the differences between crystalline solid and amorphous solid. And next one, next topic is classification. Okay, classification of crystalline solid state or crystalline solid. Classification of crystalline solid. The crystalline solid, solid substances are classified into different types. One is molecular solid. First one is molecular solid, and next one is ionic solid, and next one is metallic solid, and last property and last classification, that is covalent solid or ORR. This is also called as network solid. Network solid. So means crystalline solids are classified into four types. One is molecular solid, ionic solid, metallic solid, covalent solid or network solid. This molecular solid is again classified into three types. These are classified into three types. One is non-polar solid. First one is non-polar solid, second one is polar solid, and next one is hydrogen bond solid. Okay, so molecular solids are three types: non-polar character, based on non-polar character, that is non-polar solid, next polar solid, next hydrogen bond solid. So this is the classification. Now detail we discuss first one, molecular solid. Means in molecular solid, the molecules are shows, means the molecules are containing constant particle. The molecules, constant particles are exhibit molecular solid. These molecular solids are generally, these are non-conductors. The molecular solids are non-conductors, and these are shows less melting point and boiling point. So boiling point and melting point property is very less for molecular solid. In molecular solid, these are the soft substances. So molecular solids are soft substances. So in molecular solid, based on arrangement, based on interactions, these are classified into three types. One is non-polar solid, polar solid, hydrogen bond solid. Non-polar solid means non-polar materials like helium, neon, metals are exhibit non-polar property. So in that non-polar solid, generally here London dispersion forces. London dispersion forces are present. Means in between the molecule, in between the non-polar molecules, here now London dispersion forces are present. Means those are the attractions here. Now, polar solid. The polar solid is containing a polar bonding. So these are in between the molecules here, dipolar, dipole-dipole attractions or repulsions are present. These polar solids are shows more melting point than non-polar solid. But non-polar solid and polar solid are act as non-conductors or insulator. And last, next one for polar solid example is HCl or SO2. The non-polar solid example is neon. Next, helium. Next one is hydrogen bond solid. Here hydrogen bond, in between the, for example, in between the oxygen and nitrogen, oxygen or nitrogen, or hydrogen is interacting with more electronegative element with fluorine. So means in between the non-metals and metals, here hydrogen bonding is present. So by presence of hydrogen bonding, it shows more melting point, and these are also non-conductors. And next one is ionic solid. The ionic materials, the ionic particles, the ionic constant particles are exhibit ionic solids. So means around the nucleus, the cations and anions are surrounded together and appears as a very hard substance and brittle. These ionic solids are in solid state, these are non-conductors. But whenever these are dissolves in water or in molten state, these are exhibit conductors. Next, ionic solid. The ionic solid examples are sodium chloride, cesium chloride, or sodium bromide. These are the examples for ionic solids. In ionic solids, ionic bond is present. In molecular solid, molecular bonding is present. Next one is metallic solid. In metallic solid, generally in between the molecules or atoms or ions, metallic bond is present. So metallic solids are very hard substance. These are surrounded around the nucleus in sea of electrons. Means your electrons are freely moved, or delocalized electrons are present. Due to the presence of delocalized electrons, the metallic solids are exhibit conductance property. And next one is covalent solid or network solid. The covalent solid means in between the atoms or molecules or ions, covalent bond is present. Means mutual sharing of electrons takes place. Generally covalent solids are hard substance. The covalent solids are best example is graphite and diamond. In graphite and diamond, covalent bond is present. But diamond is a hard substance. But graphite is a soft substance. In diamond, regular arrangement, diamond is a your crystalline solid. But graphite is a amorphous solid. The graphite, in between the graphite layers, the electrons are freely delocalized in nature. Due to that, graphite exhibit conductance property. In diamond, all the particles are arranged in a fixed position and all the atoms are close together. Due to that, diamond is a non-conductor or an insulator. But diamond is a hard substance, graphite is a soft substance. These two are the examples of covalent solid or network solid.